Hi everybody, welcome back. My name is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. Today we're going over 2.4 editing images in the G Suite Learning Center for Google Sites. So this is a great thing about images, and what Google Sites allows you to do is allows you basically to grab an image from anywhere. So let's just jump into it. So I'm going to remove a section so you can see what it looks like. Anywhere that you see the little mountain with the moon, that is where an image is going to be placed. And what that looks like is it's going to look like a gray dotted box. But then when I hover over it, it's going to be blue. So this plus sign is one way that you can add an image. So if I click there, it's going to give us some options here. I can upload, I can select an image, I can grab an image from a drive, I can also add a YouTube calendar map. So it doesn't mean that an image has to go there, it just means that's where an image can go. Currently, right now, is that Google Sites does not allow you to place an image within a text box, unfortunately. Maybe that will come in the future, but as of right now, they don't do that. So here, we're just going to click on upload. When we click on upload, it's going to basically go to our desktop and it's going to allow us to go through all of our files to add pictures. I can go to iCloud Drive, I can go to Documents. Depending on what kind of computer you're on, they'll be saved in different places. But I'm just going to use this JPEG here that I created from slides. And what you'll see is that this image goes here. Now when we grab the corner, what you'll notice is that when I drag this and move this, it keeps the ratio the same. When I grab the sides or the bottom, what it will do is it'll mess up that ratio. And so you'll see that you can't see all of the image that I had originally. So if we go back and you'll see that I can drag, I want to see, we're about there. Okay, I have those options. So the other options that you'll see when I have a picture here is I have a cropping tool. When you hover over it, it tells you what you're going to do. So when I want to crop an image, it's going to allow me to zoom in or zoom out. Maybe I don't want the whole image and I just want a portion, right? Maybe it's my class pet and I really want to zoom in on my lizard's eyes or whatever. I don't know. I'm just thinking of an example that I would have. So you can do that. You also have the uncrop tool, which basically just takes it back to its natural size that you when you brought it in or its original size. When you click on link, you can also link images to other places. So if you have another page that you want this to go to, maybe you're doing a breakout room on your Google site and you have different pages that you've created that kids need to break out and they finally click on the picture. Maybe you have a Bitmoji thing that you've put together and as they're clicking on all those things, you want to have them take different places. So you have a lot of different options there. When you are done, right, you would just hit the check mark. So the other thing is you can delete the tile or the image. When we click on these three dots, we have a couple of different options. We can replace the image with an upload or select an image. We can add alt text. So the alt text, what that does is that gives us the ability to rename the image something else if it's being searched. And I would just put this as a decorative image. We'll put apply. I can also then add a caption. This is a caption, right? And that will show there. So the other way that we can pull in images, and I am going to actually delete this image and we'll bring this section back in here again. Delete this section. Is we can click on images over here. So when we already did upload, but when we select an image, we have a lot of different options. So we can upload an image by a URL. Obviously, we want to make sure that we're not breaking copyrights or anything like that. And so let's just say I found cool images of Utah, right? I like this one. If I left click on this and I see the copy image address, I just click there, come back over here, paste that URL. You see that the image is right there. I can insert that image right in that box. And you'll see that I can drag and drop. And all of my proportions are pretty good. We're gonna go back there. So there's that. We're gonna trash that. We're gonna come back over here to images again, show you some of the other options. When we click on select, you can do a Google image search, right? Cool Utah pictures. And you'll see that we have some here. My assumption is that it's a Google search, is that we're gonna have some copyright free images, maybe not. based on some of these images. Let's pull that one. We want to insert that one. You'll see, once again, that image goes there. We're going to trash can that one. We'll go back one more time. Click on images. Click on select. We can do photos. So any photos that we have here, right? So I just finished a slideshow for our school. It's the end of the year, so I have a bunch of photos from students and field trips and all these different things that the kids did. Putting them in a slideshow. I can also pull from Google Drive. And you'll see that I have all these files that I could pull from. If I went to our social media folder for this year, I don't know where it's at, but if I went to the social media folder, I could pull some files there. Again, I could also do that in a slideshow if I wanted to as well. So this has been a quick tutorial using Google Sites, how to edit images 2.4. Again, most likely you're an educator. I love you. I appreciate you. I'm glad you're here. I appreciate what you do for kids.